What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Danganronpa 2, Goodbye Despair. In the last episode, we had our party, but during a blackout, under this very table, Byakuya was... First, I should investigate the top of the table. Though, the only thing on top of this table that really catches my eye is this desk lamp. Looks like an antique lamp, and it seems rather heavy. Power cord was connected to the outlet, so it would have been useless during the blackout. Other than that, there's nothing else on the table that really stands out to me, so... Now's not the time for me to flinch. I gotta do it. I look under the table. I notice an unexplainable smell, like rusted iron, hanging in the air. During the stinging pain in the back of my eyes, I slowly shifted my gaze toward Byakuya's body. Byakuya Togami, the ultimate affluent progeny. He was the kind of guy who said a lot of hurtful things. But he tried his best to lead everyone. Why? Why did this have to end up like this? The only thing I can do right now, for Byakuya's sake, is to uncover the truth behind his death. Alright. Body is collapsed face down under the table, as if he was in the middle of attempting something. It looks like he was repeatedly stabbed between the throat and abs. Repeatedly stabbed. Would one of us really do something so horrible? Monokuma File 1 has been updated in the handbook. Check the truth bullets menu to review it. Something stuck to the back of the table. Is this duct tape? It seems to be paint applied to the non-sticky side of the duct tape. In the dim light beneath the table, it seems to glow dully. Could this be glowing paint? The knife has the paint on it, too. Possible they stole this knife from the case, or they hid it somewhere hard to find? There's also some kind of paint that- Alright, Hajime, you're just as dumb as Makoto. Oh no, actually, wow! Hajime actually put two and two together! I think. These night vision goggles. Yeah, these are night vision goggles. Hajime, those aren't binoculars. Those are probably night vision goggles. Night vision goggles? I've seen them at the supermarket on this island. They also stock self-defense kits, too. That's the case. Did the killer use these night vision goggles to kill Byakuya during the blackout? Is there any bloodstain? I guess. Blood flowing from Byakuya's body formed a huge pool under the table. There's a lot of blood. There's blood spattered everywhere. Even the inner side of the tablecloth is covered in blood. The blood might have splattered all over the place when he got stabbed. But there don't seem to be any drag marks leading from the pool, from the blood pool. I'm sure I've pretty much investigated what's under the table. Despite the fact it's just me, I think I'm working pretty hard. If it's just a little, I'm sure we're getting close to the truth beyond Byakuya's death. I must investigate my classmate's body. I'm the one who has medical knowledge. That's why I need to do it. To do it somehow. Before you start, why don't you calm down a bit? You're right. I need to calm down first. I'm careless enough as it is. That's pretty obvious from how you fell earlier. Terry, sorry about that, for showing you something so unsightly. You made me remember it again. I made such a fool of myself in front of everyone. Forget making a fool of yourself. How in the world did you end up like that? Well, I got startled by the blackout, slipped on the carpet, and once I was struggling to get back up. It's so embarrassing. Please, erase it from your memory. Even if you ask me, I won't be able to forget it so easily. Sorry. I can't stand it. Alright, Nagato, what have you got? There's something I want to run by you. Before the blackout occurred, Byakuya was in the dining hall with the rest of us, right? Yeah. If Byakuya's dead body was discovered after the blackout, then don't you think he died during the blackout? Well, now that you mention it, but why was Byakuya's body under the table? Even if the killer tried to hide him, it's not like he would have stayed hidden forever. Isn't it confusing? You're absolutely right. Seems finding out exactly what happened during the blackout is key to solving the mystery. There's no way I'd know. So it was so dark during the blackout I couldn't see a thing. That's not Although, if seeing was impossible, then there's a possibility somebody might have heard something. Heard something? Are you talking about her? I don't know which... Oh! Minami! Mahiro, are you alright? Yeah, I'm fine. Is that what you expected me to say? Because I feel terrible. One of Byakuya is alive and well, in an instant something awful suddenly happens. Of course I'm not fine. Not only that, but whoever killed him is one of us, right? That hasn't been determined yet. It's already been determined. You've already accepted it, haven't you? That we have to find out who the killer is? Find out which friend killed our friend? I don't like it either, but we won't survive if we don't go through with it. It's not just for yourself. We have to do it to protect all of us. If only I'd acted calmer during the blackout, Byakuya might still be alive. This whole thing never would have happened. Stop blaming yourself. Nothing good will come of it. Getting cheered up by a boy isn't like me at all. Hey, Hajime, forget what I just said. Got it? Yeah, fine. I got it. I won't dwell on it for now. I can't become a burden to everyone. Plus, there might be a clue that only I have access to. Photos, the ones I took just before the blackout, remember? That's a cannon. Hey, Byakuya, everyone, come on, I'm gonna take a picture. Say cheese. Oh yeah, the pictures. Wanna see them? I have a digital camera, so I could show them to you right now. Really? Please. See, it's this photo. And this one. These two photos right before the blackout, but... Huh? Something wrong? Didn't realize it till just now, but right before the blackout, Byakuya was standing in a totally different place than where we found him. Wasn't his body under the table with the lamp on top of it? The one underneath the monitor? Prior to that, Byakuya was standing along the wall farthest away from the table. You're right, that's pretty far. There's something... Everyone's standing position before the blackout might be a huge clue. Hey, can you approximate everybody's standing position from these photos? Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. It'd be hard to understand from the photos alone, so it might be better for me to plot it out. But would that actually provide a clue? I don't know yet, but I feel like it could. Leave it to me. Got it, then leave it to me. That's pretty much the only job I can do anyway. Right now? Alright, now that that's decided, you better work hard on your investigation too. How much longer are you planning to stand around? Do you understand what's going on? You gotta find out how Byakuya died. I know, but she's a totally different person than she was when she was feeling down. Oh, Hellhound Earring, answer my call! Is this effort futile as well? Are you still looking for the earring you dropped? No, it's not a mere earring, it is a Hellhound Earring! Long ago, in a faraway land, a beast known as the Hellhound was feared by all, even by he who summoned it. Well, this is certainly random. The Hellhound tore its way through innumerable battlefields, its fangs glistening with blood, and his drenched blood-red fur would dry in the howling winds of loneliness. When I finally tamed that diabolic beast, it received an earring to commemorate that event. The Hellhound Earring. So that I may never forget the night I battled that fearsome Pomeranian. I wear that earring at all times. Was that really about a friggin' Pomeranian? I understand it's important to you, but for now we need to investigate. Where is it? Where did it disappear to? Maybe it fell underneath the floor? The carpet didn't cover the whole floor. It might have fallen through the gaps that exposed floorboards. So that's what transpired. Such a clever little bauble. Ah, there it is. I found it. Truly, that is the Hellhound Earring. Seems God exists for my benefit. Good for you. However, how do I recover it? I cannot fit my arm through this opening. Were I to use a tool, it would probably not reach either. Maybe you should just give up. Give up what? The world? I meant give up the earring. Fool, have you not yet realized the world would come to an end if the human race were to lose that earring? You humans are so satisfied with clothing yourselves in layers of false knowledge. But even with all those layers, you still will not survive the winter. I do not like this guy. Holy crap, I do not like this guy. Is that everything I have in here? Maybe investigate the other. Yeah, it was worth checking. All right. Air conditioner? Could it be? Hey, all of you, why can't you act a little more grown up? Oh, what was that sound just now? Someone turned on the air conditioner, and that's what caused the blackout. The air conditioner is probably the only machine inside this room. The air conditioner's remote control. The timer is set to 11:30. Pretty sure Byakuya's time of death was around the same time. So, that means the mechanical sound before the blackout probably came from this air conditioner. My flashes of inspiration aren't as bad as I thought. The AC timer was added to the truth bullets section in the handbook. Alright, what now? Okay. I mean, I guess that's the case. Last time I saw it, it was closed, but there are a lot of odd things in this case, like a nightstick and pepper spray. Huh? What's this? A hard plastic case. But it's just the case, the inside is empty. I wonder what was inside. But the one thing that really catches my attention is this small key. It must be the key to the other Duralumin case. That other case was in the office, and all of the collected dangerous items were inside it. The key to that Duralumin case is right here, and it's unlikely that the murder weapon used to kill Byakuya was taken from that case. Which means the weapons in that are not related to the murder. Even so, I still don't get it. Why did Byakuya have this Duralumin case in the first place? A case packed with all the security equipment? Maybe he was just being extra cautious, just in case? No, that can't be right. That's way too overboard. Could he have known something was going to happen beforehand? And because of that, he went through all this trouble to be extra careful? The Duralumin case has been added to the truth bullets section of your handbook. Now then, what else should I investigate? Hajime, a moment. We're finished with the investigation here. Would you like to hear what everyone has to say together? If I go by myself, some people might not talk to me out of caution. Well, we've been told that everyone is a killer. That one of us is a killer. Wow. Can't be helped if everyone's on edge right now. But why me? You're easy to talk to, and I feel like you have a scent similar to mine. We both harbor special feelings towards Hope's Peak Academy, isn't that right? Well, yeah, but... Fine. If we're going together, let's get on with it. There's no time for idle chit-chat. I'm glad. It'll be a great help. What he said about us being similar, I don't think I agree. I guess for now, we should search the inside of this old building and listen to what the others have to say. Not just the dining hall, but we should consider this whole building the scene of the crime. After all, the blackout that took place at the time would have happened throughout this entire building. Yeah, you're right. Oh, Jesus! Hi, Ibuki. Apparently, a great man once said investigations should be done on foot. So that's why I'm also using my feet. I'm just walking around for no particular reason. Well, if there's no reason, then there's no meaning. Hey, Hajime, I just realized something. Could she, by any chance, know what happened during the blackout?
Are you serious?
How'd you know? So you did hear us, even though Hajime and I were talking pretty softly just now. Not only do I have a perfect face, style, and personality, but I also have perfect ears. If your hearing is so good, maybe you heard what actually happened during the blackout. When the blackout happened, you could hear everybody's voice throughout the dining hall, right? We couldn't tell, but would you have been able to make out who- You would have been able to make out who's who, right? Just leave it to Ibuki. It'll be easy as fried rice with gravy. La-di-la-da, I'll heartily eat it for breakfast. Oh, easy as pie, except eating fried rice with gravy for breakfast is kind of heavy. Any fried rice that isn't fried rice with gravy is so wrong. She should make a metaphor with more common type of fried rice, like egg fried rice or lettuce fried rice. Can you tell us what you heard? Wait. The first person who raised their voice during the blackout was... It was Mahiro. Next was Kazuichi's voice, and the next voice was mine. What a nice remark I made. It's to the point and it has its own unique charm. Just continue. Then there was more voices, one after the other. Alrighty, that's pretty much it. Aren't I awesome? Praise me, praise me. Give me lots of praise. I heard you the first time. Seriously, don't get any closer. Hinakuto, say something to her. Hey, did something happen? No, I was just thinking about what Byakuya said during the blackout. Why did he say something like that? Rather, why was he able to say that? What the hell? What's going on here? This is... What do you mean? About that, why don't we discuss it after we've investigated a little more? For now, I can't really say anything for certain. Yep. Anyway, don't you think Ibuki's account just now is an important clue that'll lead us to the truth? Then praise me, let me bite ya! Ouch! Why are you actually biting me? Alright. Alright, is the toilet still locked? There's no response. This is going nowhere. Guess we should give up for now and check on it later. Alright, to the office. Circuit breaker, huh? It might be related to the blackout. It's better if we check out the circuit breaker first. Where's the circuit breaker? Why is it so high up? Damn. Blackout probably happened because of this. It doesn't look like someone did anything to it. Nothing else looks suspicious either. Circuit breaker is pretty high up. Even if you use a stepladder, you won't reach it. That's why it's so mysterious. During the blackout, I was panicking so bad I forgot about that, but... You're right, even with a stepladder, there's no way you'd be able to reach the circuit breaker. Which means someone must have reset the breaker after the blackout, but who? I did it! You idiots had no idea what to do about the blackout, so I'm the one who reset the circuit breaker. Ah, by the way, I'm not the one who tripped the breaker. The killer did that, of course. How did someone as small as you reset the breaker? Well, firstly, my eyes work real good at night, so I have no trouble seeing in the dark. And if you want to know how I reached the circuit breaker, my body stretches. You know, I'm very elastic. Liar! I'm serious, wanna see? Wanna see a new version of Monokuma with his body all stretched out? It's gross, it's grotesque. No thanks, just imagining it makes me want to puke. Oh really? Such a shame. Still, don't you think Monokuma's such a nice guy? In a popularity contest, he'd take first place. What the hell? So he's the one who reset the breaker? Well, in that case, I'm convinced. There's no way we'd be able to reach that. If that's the case, how'd the killer trip the circuit breaker? They didn't trip it or set it to be tripped. Timer here is set to 11:30. Wasn't the timer in the one in the dining hall also set for that time? Can't be a coincidence, right? Hey Pekka, what do you got? You doubt me, correct? However, it does not surprise me. An unexpected blackout occurred. During that time, Byakuya was killed. The circuit breaker is in this office. Naturally, I look suspicious since I was supposed to be here. Wait. Supposed to be here? Does that mean... So I was right, you weren't in the office. But why? Weren't you supposed to guard the circuit breaker and the Duralumin case with all the weapons in it? So where'd you run off to on your own? Well, that is... Pekko suddenly dropped one knee and started groaning on the spot. Hey, what happened? No, I'm just not feeling too well. I apologize, but excuse me. It appears the bathroom inside this old building is currently occupied, so I recommend either the hotel lobby or your cottage. Seems like it will be a tough path. With cold sweat dripping from her forehead, Pekko wobbled out of the office. What happened to her? It's kind of hard for me to say it myself. I already feel bad enough for Pekko as it is. She didn't, like, run away or anything. Because if she ran away, she's obviously the killer. I'm almost positive. Where's my cursor? There it is. Hey, isn't Pekko the killer? Well, she wandered off somewhere even though she was supposed to be in the office. When we were looking for Byakuya after the blackout, I went to the office right away, but when I got here, she was gone. I shouldn't say this too loudly or else Miss Sonia will yell at me. Pekko's probably the one who tripped the circuit breaker and used the blackout to her advantage to kill Byakuya. Don't you think she looks kind of ruthless too? Like an assassin, right? Well, it's not like you look any better. And this is still locked. Maybe we should check inside just to be safe, but it's locked. Byakuya had the key. Of course you did, Nagato. He does not feel any remorse. See, it's open. Forks, kitchen knives, iron skewers, and various tools are crammed inside. It's not possible that the killer took anything from here, because the key to this case was inside the case Byakuya had with him. Now then, I guess we're done with the office, don't you think? We should get going. Alright, so the kitchen and the storage room, right? Oh, let me see if anybody's over here. No, okay. Can I get your account? There is something I want to ask you. First, is that only that wall is a different color and material? Why is that? Oh, it's probably a fire door. Fire door? You ever seen one before? A door that shuts to keep fire from spreading by containing it. If that happens, you can run away, right? I see. It is like a barrier. Just like lining up plastic bottles around the house. It's only done to keep cats from getting in. You know about keeping cats from getting inside, but you don't know about fire doors? Truly, I'm culturally ignorant. I'm ashamed of myself. Fire door has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Alright, into the kitchen. Hello, Teru Teru. You were in the kitchen during... Were you in the kitchen during the blackout? The blackout totally startled me. At first, I thought it was just in the kitchen. But when I finally managed to get out of the kitchen, the hallway was pitch black too. Then I heard everybody's voices, so I fumbled along the wall and tried to feel my way to the dining hall. But that place was pitch black too. It was like pitch black everywhere. Couldn't you have used that kitchen stove as a light? Ah, that's impossible. The gas stove needs electricity to work, so it was directly affected by the blackout. I guess it's not possible. Since you work with fire in the kitchen, I figured you'd be able to use that as a light source or something, but I guess it's not that easy. Terotero's account has been added to the truth bullet section of the handbook. Real quick, just to make sure. Yeah, I had a feeling. Presents. Yeah, you can take the jeans. Cool. Chinese, okay. Isn't it amazing the meat is so big? Even I was shocked. It's a dish fit for a tropical island. I'd never be able to get meat like this in Ayama or Azabu. I'd never be able to get meat like this in my hometown, much less Ayama. I get it, you don't have to repeat yourself, but it's so big, where'd you get it? I asked Nekomaru. Apparently, he killed the cow at the ranch with his bare hands and brought it over. His bare hands? It's a little hard to believe, but it doesn't seem completely impossible either. Those hands of his, they look like they specialize in punching things. Wouldn't want to get punched by those hands. Seriously, Nekomaru's so wild. He's totally right at home in a country setting, I'm so jealous. My hometown is near Oyama and Azabu. So wild country things like that, they slip my mind a lot. You know? Well, I guess this meat has gone to waste, since this awfulness happened right when the party started. The only ones who ate any food were Akane and Peko, who took some portions for herself. I worked so hard to cook the world's most refined party dishes, only two people actually tasted them. Well, it's not like I actually believe it, but if there really is a killer out there, I'll probably never be able to forgive that killer. The party dishes have been added to the truth bullets. What do you got, Nagato? Yeah, we already got a couple of clues. Well, just from reading through this list, it looks like the knife next to Byakuya's body didn't come from the kitchen. It appears to have been brought from outside. And how did the killer get past Byakuya's body check? He didn't even go easy on the girls when he was performing the pat-downs. Probably brought the knife in advance and hid it somewhere. Still, it's surprising how much equipment this kitchen has. There are iron plates for barbecuing and even a portable stove for cooking hotspots. But this is all the stuff that doesn't pertain to the murder, so I guess it doesn't really matter. Yeah. This is... I have a few ideas, I'm just not entirely sure. How come Byakuya was able to say something like that in the darkness? Like, what the hell, what's going on here, or this is... It makes me wonder. And this is the only room left, so... storage room really is dusty and dark. My hands were full cleaning the dining hall, so I couldn't even touch this room. Even as cobwebs, there's no way I could stay in here for a long time. Are these irons? Looks like they were recently turned on, but why are there three irons on this ironing board? Your eyes don't miss a thing. When I was looking for Byakuya after the blackout, I also found these irons, but when I found them, all three of them were turned on. It'd be bad if another blackout happened, so I turned them all off. Doesn't this feel kind of sinister? I see. There's an awful lot of boxes. A wise decision. Huge piece of cloth. A tablecloth? Wait, there's something on it. A blood stain? Come here, take a closer look. There's no mistaking, this is clearly a blood stain, which means this tablecloth is connected to Byakuya's murder. This tablecloth has a blood... Okay, so somebody stabbed him, used that tablecloth to move him, put him under... That's why there are no drag marks. How much longer are you going to stay in this dark place? You're just wasting your time. You're right. Yeah, you're right. There's not really anywhere else in this room? Yep. We pretty much finished looking around the old building. How about we check on Byakuya's cottage? Yep. There might be clues there, so I thought it'd be good to check it out just in case. I don't really mind going there, but are you worried that the possibility that I might be in danger? You mean am I worried about you being the killer? To be honest, I don't think you're the killer. In fact, I can't even imagine it. It's like, instead of living with doubt in others, it's so much better to die believing in others. We're doing this so that we can live, you know? You sure are strong. You're definitely the chosen one, chosen by Hope's Peak Academy. Alright, let's get going to Byakuya's cottage. I don't know why, but every time we talk, I don't really know how I'm supposed to react. Okay. It's worth checking, I guess. See? Hey. Carpet I laid didn't reach the table when we found Byakuya's body, right? And the dining hall floor had huge gaps between the floorboards. The killer killed Byakuya by stabbing him from beneath the floor? Yep. That's what I thought, so I'm trying to see if we could get under it from here. Well, I guess it's not possible to get under the floor from outside. The building is surrounded by firm fences, so there's no way to sneak under the floor from here. Couldn't find a way to get under the floor from inside the building either. Is it a hidden hole? If you get under the floor, there'd only be one logical suspect. The only person who didn't come to the party and also doesn't have an alibi. Alright, Fuyuhiko. I suspected him too, that's why I was checking to see if it's possible to get under the floor from outside. Speaking of which, not long after I began guarding the entrance, Fuyuhiko came here. What happened, Fuyuhiko? Oh, hey, what are you doing here, all alone at a place like this? Yep. I'm standing guard so Monokuma doesn't come inside. How diligent of you. Hey. You're not coming to the party? Hell no, not even if you paid me. Parties are stupid, they make me want to puke. You want to come to the party, right? Isn't that why you came here? Of course not, I was just going for a damn walk. Do I have to report to you every time I wanted to go for a fucking walk? No, it's not like that, but... Then leave me alone. And then he just left. Why did he come here? He probably wants to be a part of the group, but he can't be honest about it. He believes he's different from everyone else. That's why he's always alone. He's like the main character of an RPG. Have you played those before? When did we start talking about games? Shiaki's account was added to the truth bullet section of the handbook. Even though we don't really know what he's thinking, I don't think we have any reason to doubt him. It's a relief. I'm glad. Keep saying you're glad, but we have no idea who the killer is. Well, I guess for now, we should stick to the plan and head over to Byakuya's cottage. As long as the probability is greater than zero, that will suffice. We'll most assuredly reclaim the Hellhound earring with my own two hands. He doesn't want to investigate. Alright, to Byakuya's cottage. Hey. What the hell? Didn't I tell you to leave me alone? Didn't you hear Monokuma's announcement? Of course I did. Apparently Byakuya's the one who got killed. So what? What did you say? Do you think I'm the killer? Think whatever you want. I'm used to being mistrusted. That's not why I'm... Just tell me why you're doing... Well, everyone else at the party. Checking my alibi, huh? Well, I don't have one. I was just chilling in my cottage all by myself during that time. The whole time? Because Chiaki said she saw you in front of the old building. Nosy bitch. It's true I went for a little walk, and just by chance I ended up passing by the old building. Were you really going for a walk? Don't tell me you were actually trying to join the party. Why the hell would I do that? It's a coincidence! A coincidence! Alright, I got it. Dumbass. Good grief. Alright, where is Byakuya? He's... this one right next to mine, I think. Oh, what? What's it gonna be? Huh? It's locked. I guess we need to ask him for help. Hey! Monokuma! Yay! Did you call me? Nagato, when did you train Monokuma? Hey Monokuma, I was wondering if you could do us a favor. There's something we want to investigate. I can even play soccer by myself as long as I have this cloning technique. Though I'd be boring to play alone. I don't have time for this. Just hurry up and open Byakuya's cottage already. This is for the class trial. It's something we really need. For the class trial? If it's for the class trial, there's no way I can refuse. Now then, there's only one spell that can open these doors. How did that work? Why does it open with a magic spell? Probably powered by electricity. At any rate, that performance was a waste of time. We should go inside then. That is a letter. It's an envelope on the table. It's a letter someone sent to Byakuya? There's no sender. That looks pretty suspicious. Should check inside. Be careful. The first kill will happen tonight. Someone will definitely kill someone. This is... a crime warning? No, if it says be careful, it's probably a threatening letter. Regardless, who would send something like this? This is why Byakuya suddenly declared to throw a party. The first kill will happen tonight, because someone made this threat to Byakuya. He gathered everyone in one area and was extremely cautious about all the dangerous items. He's trying to create a scenario in which everyone could monitor each other. He thought if he did that, nobody would be able to kill anyone. So, he believed this crazy letter? He couldn't ignore the possibility of this happening, even if it was just a worst case scenario. Remember what Byakuya kept saying? How he wouldn't let anyone become a victim? He couldn't overlook that slim possibility just to keep his promise. Then, why did he keep it a secret if he just told us? He probably couldn't. He probably thought that was also a worst case scenario. If everyone knew what was in the letter, whether it's a lie or not, everyone would have likely begun to doubt each other, and at that point there'd be no turning back. So, Byakuya tried to do something about all this by himself without telling anyone? His strong sense of responsibility is the only explanation I can think of. Anyway, whoever sent Byakuya this letter also killed him. Is that what you're saying? No, this could be a prank, and it might have nothing to do with Byakuya's death at all. He doesn't want to believe one of us could be a killer. But still, we've come all the way here, and it's the only thing I can think of. The person who wrote this letter murdered Byakuya. If that's the case, that person completely predicted how Byakuya would react once he received it, right? They planned to manipulate Byakuya, and killed him right before our eyes, in that old building. Damn it, who the hell would do that? Murder threat has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Hajime, there's probably not much time left until the class trial starts. Probably. Which reminds me, you asked Mahiro for a favor earlier, right? Yeah, I wanted her to find out where everybody was standing just before the blackout. She's probably finished by now, you're coming with me, right? Sorry, that's all you. I need some time alone. I like some time to collect my thoughts. I see, I understand. Also, if you're going back to the old building, you should hear what Mikan has to say as well. I think the results of her autopsy should be ready by now. I'll see you later. He was pretty pale. I wonder if he's okay. But now's not the time to worry about Nagito. There isn't much time left, so I gotta hurry over to the old building. I'm getting turned around. Where am I? Hey, Fuyuhiko. Hello, butterflies. I mean, pigeons. Is this a pigeon? It's a pigeon. What the? What was that loud voice? Feel so lighthearted right now. I, Nekomaru Nidai, have been reborn. I have no intention of losing anymore. Losing to who? I won't lose to anyone, not even to my past self. That sounds cool and all, but what are you even talking about? Shit! I don't know who was behind it, but someone tried to make a shitty bastard out of me. Some scoundrel was occupying the bathroom before the party was about to start. Now that you mention it, you said something like that shortly after the party started. I've been trying to use it many times, but the door just won't open at all. However, if you think I'd be angered by something like that, you've all underestimated my nerve and patience. Dwell and achieve all with one's presence of mind. That is the goal of a true leader. In other words, a leader must never falter in any situation, but always have the presence in one's mind. He says that, but I'm pretty sure he was shaken up by the whole ordeal. Oh well, best not to go into it. So you're saying the bathroom door was shut from before the party was started to after the blackout? So what I mean is... And the bathroom was finally unoccupied after Byakuya's body was found. That's about how long that lasted. I should remember that, just in case. Nekomaru's account has been added to the truth bullets section of the handbook. So is anybody in the bathroom now? Leave no stone unturned, Hajime. Goddamn. Alright, Mika. What do you got? Did you find out anything? Man, I discovered there are several puncture wounds to the chest and abs region. Deep wounds deep enough to reach his lungs and internal organs. Very thin, sharp object around 5 millimeters in diameter was used to stab him over and over again, which is what I believe. Are you okay? Talking about it made me sad. No need to push yourself. I got the gist of what you wanted to say. 5 millimeters in diameter, huh? Isn't that pretty thin? It's as thin as an ice pick or an owl. All. Owl? All. All. Alright, Mahiro. You're here! Where the hell did you wander off to? I wasn't wandering, I was investigating as much as I could. If we weren't slacking off, then I guess it's fine. Did you find anything? Sorta. Let's take a look at this. Just as you told me, using the two photos I took before the blackout. I tried to pinpoint where everyone was standing. When I did, this diagram was the result. So, this is everyone's standing position before the blackout. Everyone's pretty much in the dining hall. Made this diagram from analyzing those photos, so I'm pretty sure it's accurate. Just as I thought, Byakuya was standing a far distance from the table. It's impossible, there's no way he'd be able to move that far during the blackout. What's this line extending from the table where Byakuya was killed? It's a desk lamp, I drew the power cord for it just in case. Power cord for the desk lamp? That cord was extending from the table where Byakuya was killed, that means... So, did you find anything? It's not clear to me yet, but... I didn't really understand it myself when I was drawing it. I have a feeling that's either a potential clue or just a waste of labor. No, it wasn't a waste at all. It's not clear to me yet, but there's no mistake that a clue is hidden here. An extremely important clue. Oh, finally.
Alrighty, guys! It's finally time!
That's here we go.
Of Jabberwock Island, there is a mountain with my adorable face carved into it. That, my friends, is Monokuma Rock. Once you're there, please proceed to the underground by taking the elevator located at the secret entrance. I'll see you soon.
Mountain with a carving of Monokuma's face at the central island? Well, it's almost time. But that's it for today. I'd like to thank you all for watching. And next time on Danganronpa 2, Goodbye Despair, we'll be heading... Oh, hold on. This is important. Dear Lord. Okay. We'll be heading to Monokuma Rock. for our class trial. See you guys then.